Unfortunately for you, I am the High King of Riverhelm. Now you may be asking yourself, or me, or whoever the fuck, I don't know. How did you become the King of Riverhelm? What did you have to do? Did you have to slay all of the citizens of Skyrim? Did you have to convince some asshole that you were worthy by going on some meaningless quest? Absolutely not. This is how I became King of Riverhelm. So hello everybody and welcome to, the first, go away. Trying to do an intro over here. Please leave me alone. Why does this always happen? I hate you. Oh my god, it's the Headless Horseman. What are you doing in my mod? Okay, so this is, as usual, a mod playthrough. I haven't done this in a long time since my computer went down, my, Skyrim series started up, and, just so many things. But this mod, as you may already know from the title, as well as, the earlier intro, that this is Elsie's Become King of Riverhelm. And this is a mod by Locaster, who you may know doing a lot of different mods. But I was requested to do this one in particular because they wanted to know if this held up or above High King of Skyrim, as well as if it was compatible with High King of Skyrim. And as you can see right now, I am definitely playing with High King of Skyrim on, as well as this wonderful mod. Now, would I say, right off the bat, would I say this is better than High King of Skyrim? I'm not going to say that, and I'm not going to say it's worse either. What I'm going to say is they play very well together. I would not recommend not having either one. I mean, either one is very good. What the fuck is this, a Thalmor? Excuse me.
It's immoral. Perhaps there's something you wished.
I don't.
Incorrect.
I can worship anyway. Why? Blah blah blah. I just want to kill this guy. Sorry. And then get away with it. Oh, oh! I'm trying to smash his head in. Oh, don't worry. That guy's got it. Oh, good. But either way, I really like both mods, and I really like this mod. It adds a lot of things. I know he made another mod that's in the same vein as these kind of things, called Become Jarl of Iverstead. And I will be checking that one out very soon as well, seeing how this one holds up against that. But I think this one definitely is one to go for if you don't quite... If High King of Skyrim just isn't quite working for you, this is definitely the one to go for, because this one is definitely updated very regularly. The mod creator is very well-known and makes a lot of mods, but let's get off into this. Where is Riverhelm? Well, as you can see on the map, it's right between Riverwood and Whiterun. And it's pretty cool, just to note right away, it is absolutely huge. What the fuck's going on over there? Whatever, it died. It is absolutely huge, this place. So that's just really awesome, just right off the bat. Random spell sword, apparently, trying to kill me. But, as you can see, it's also, you know, there's just guards everywhere. It's awesome. It's beautiful. And it's just really aesthetically pleasing. One thing to note, as soon as we get up to these guards, you'll notice, it's very medieval looking. By which I mean, like, classic medieval fantasy kind of look. So we're just going to talk to this
River
guy.
Helm, my land, my city.
And as you can kind of see, there's nice dialogue with
the
these
shore, citizen. I am here to
these two guards right here, so you can kind of mount a defense and actually have kind of a siege going on here. So going through things, I've already looked at this all. Obviously, I've become king already, but I just wanted to point out some key landmarks. You know, we got the Riverhelm Temple right here. The first thing you walk up to is the castle. Absolutely could. kind of funny that these are very well voice acted. It seems by either one or two of the same people. At least the males are. I think the females have a couple voice actors as well. This guy lets you recruit a bunch of people for an army. These catapults are usable. I thought that was pretty sweet. But it does look like you're attacking White Run. I don't know, that's kind of fucked up, isn't it? And you can kind of see again from the guards, they look very medieval, European, British to be more specific. But very, I don't want to say low fantasy, but definitely out of the vein of Skyrim in particular. That is a nice little farmhouse style place. That's just a worker house. So right where we're going right now is the main city, which is kind of interesting to know. It is above the castle, which is a little abnormal for castles in general. Considering usually, oh god, I forgot the buggy guard. Here, let's join him. When the enemy... As you can see right now, the guards treat me as a normal citizen of Riverhelm. So that's kind of interesting to note. I should also point out, I am not my character from Surviving Skyrim. This is a second character I made. He's like level 102 or something. And he's just kind of really nuts. And he's just for these mod reviews. Hello. So you can get another feel, like, there's definitely more than one male actor. Let's see if we can find a...
Need something?
I'm not hearing the female actor. I could have swore there was one, but apparently I'm mistaken. Some of the dialogue needs work, just, because it's... I don't want to say typoed per se, but it is, some grammatical errors, but otherwise... See, so right there, I am here for protect you. Just pointing that out, Riverhelm Arena.
The melee fighters are your ramparts. The healer is like the moats. Archers are well, archers. The partisans.
That follower I have right now is from the interesting NPCs. So there's another grammatical error in that one. I don't remember what it was, but we're just skipping around. So, Hunter's Guild, so places like that in the Grange, the Blacksmith as well. Let's see if we can get down to this guy. He's still here. Okay, yeah. So we can just talk to this guy, and we can make investments in these places. So, obviously, you can see the places, buy a house.
Please take this key off your house.
So, just as an example, we're going to go check that out in a second, but not before we come up here. We're going to check out the arena after as well, so we're just going to skip that. Where is it? There it is. So, we're going down here to Riverhelm Manor, and Riverhelm Manor is where you would be living if you became a knight, and there is this cross-dressing knight, apparently. That needs gender swapped, but I don't care. He can walk like a girl, I don't. So, as you can see, there's this little cheat thing right here that just gives you everything you need. So, you know, you want the mines key, which makes it the most money, obviously. The castle key and the knight's key, and then right here, you have the, titles for said things. And you need the title for this room. There's an arcane enchanter here, a knight's salary right here. So we're going to go to the castle right now, and we're going to purchase the knight title. I'm going to do the knight one first just to show the difference between being a knight and a civilian, and then I will proceed to become the king. But I thought it was important to show the difference between civilian and knight, first and foremost. Hello, traveler. And see, you can kind of see some weird things in just the dialogue wording of things. It's a little awkward, but, you know, nothing really to complain about, especially considering something like High King of Skyrim doesn't have any voice acting at all. And not to mention, it straight up breaks the fourth wall. So we're going to tech to this fellow, the Baron.
Greetings, good sir.
So we want to purchase some stuff, and we're going to become, gonna buy the mine. Produces a revenue of 1,500. So obviously we get 1,500 gold a day. And I don't remember where the chest is, so I'm not gonna show you that. I don't think I actually found the mine, so
the chest will contain your salary of 1,000 gold.
So now we're a knight.
Knight.
So now we see we fight with Honor Knight. Oops.
Yeah. Why?
Sorry, lady. Fuck. I'm just trying to get these guys to talk to me. Thank you.
Greetings, knight.
So we'll walk by this guy. Hello.
Your bravery inspires the army, sir.
Hail knight. Alright, so you get a good idea of that. We're gonna go back to the city. Again, I don't know where the mine is. I'd love to show you that, but I've looked all over. I can't find it. I'm sure I'll find it as we go along this, though. That's the beauty of being a playthrough rather than just me showing you stuff. I will consider doing a showcase or something like that with this as well. It's been a while since I've done that, so I may not. This also is, it's very supported. It's updated regular and recently, so that's an important thing to note. And so, you know, it's definitely reliable, to say the least. I know the mod creator fixes a lot of compatibility issues, and that's probably one of the reasons why it works with High King of Skyrim. Hello, Buggy Knight. So we're just gonna walk up to this place real quick. Ignore the boobs. That's just how the statue of Dibella rolls, as you can see. See, just how she rolls. What is that? That's neat. Oh, I know that. That's from the thieves. Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't join any such guild.
Take a look.
All right. So we can just decorate our house with this kind of stuff. I was wondering what this was. I never walked in here. I thought I'd be able to, like, buy improvements to my house? At least that's what I thought. That's quite strange, but I guess it's just decorations. Alright, good thing to note. I never bothered walking in there because it just says home decor shop, so I just assumed what it was. Obviously, we've got the ingredient shop there, so, you know, basic potions and stuff. Bakery, it sells, special pies that heal for a lot, which is cool. So we're just gonna head down to the manor down here, which I'm much more interested in than the house, because the house is very lackluster, to say the least. It's very normal. So obviously cheap box still there. So we got the knight salary right here. So we're just gonna pop that in our inventory, and we activate it, so we don't, you know, salary for 400 for a day of service, so now we can open this door. And there's some books all over. For some reason, it's, like, literally all over. I don't know what happened here, but could be just one of those same Skyrim bugs that tends to happen. We're going to pick up this knight armor because it's actually really cool armor. Oops. That's not what I wanted. Oh, that's not what I wanted to pick up either. There we go. And check that out. That is, like, it makes me look swole as fuck, I should also mention. Let's take that off. So, like, just Jesus Christ. Like I said, swole as fuck. It does look like fantastic armor, though. And as I said before, it's very, very medieval looking. Something like you'd find from Oblivion, or what you should see from Knights from High Rock, the Bretons. So this would fit perfectly with a Breton. Not as much with a Nord, but definitely 100% a Breton. I was definitely considering actually rolling a Breton just for that purpose, because, I don't know, it looks very medieval, and that's kind of how Bretons actually are. Funnily enough, obviously, if you may already know this, but Bretons are very much old word for the Britons, so there is that. Buggy Knight, hello, let me join you.
Noble Knight of River.
So as you can see, you know, they all call you a knight as well, so you there's dialogue changes when you upgrade your title. Which is pretty cool. And we're heading where again? Yeah, down here.
Your bravery inspires oh, wrong way. Army, sir.
Thank you, I guess. It is kind of funny that the guards randomly will just use random guard dialogue. It's interesting to say the least. Quite strange. We also have this. Sorry. I have this jester here who seems like he would use the scripts from the the one dragon shout that taunts you. I don't remember, but it's like, hey cheese breath, hey ugly, says all that kind of stuff, and that seems like what he should be saying, but for some reason he doesn't with me. Not sure why.
Greetings.
So we're gonna keep doing this. We're gonna become the king.
It's a relief to know that Riverhelm will have a king once more. You must be very wealthy. We all know that the kingdom of Riverhelm is worth much more than you paid. But during war, it's difficult to find anyone with pockets as deep as yours. Congratulations. An excellent purchase. Now, please kneel and I swear to govern and defend the people of Riverhelm with courage and wisdom. I swear by the steel of my sword. The fire of my spirit, and as God is, I will combat evil, tyranny, and injustice. Rise now, King of Riverhelm. Long live the king.
So obviously now I've become King of Riverhelm, and as such, I will be treated differently. So we're gonna talk to this guy as well. So there's this dialogue that says, "General, how can I expand my kingdom?"
You know. You can help the Arthur Lowcaster
and
expand your kingdom.
Suddenly, wall breaking forth.
To donate, go to
wall breaking of the fourth kind.
mods.com. Search for the original Become the King of Riverhelm mod and click the donate to this user link next to the screenshots. Making a donation is a heroic way to thank the author and encourage him to continue his work. Thank you for your support.
So, kind of a funny little fourth wall breaking to kind of encourage donating. It's kind of funny, and I like
yes,
it.
My lord. You now have
but we can also change these different armors. But honestly, I really just like the Riverhelm medieval armor, so I'm going to stick with it. Steel armor has always been like kind of meh, and ancient Nord armor just looks so skimpy. I don't know. Describe it, but we're gonna go up to the city once more, just real quick to we're gonna check out the arena, and then we're going to also just get some random guard dialogue action, pretty much. Nothing much more coming from that. Oh shit, Tina, you scared the shit out of me. but other than that, that's pretty much the wrap up. For the city itself. Oh god, the buggy guard. Hello.
Save the king of Riverhelm.
Yeah, save the king. Kind of interesting dialogue. I don't know. Is that what generally they say, you know what I mean? It's just a bit strange. Can't eat those rabbit legs or I will literally die. So we're just going to the arena real quick, and you can kind of already hear a lot of the new guard dialogue. Citizen dialogue is pretty similar. It's all in the same vein, but it's pretty cool that it you know, all this stuff is voice acted, and you can see that, you know, the, I'm so sorry. It's my heavy armor, I swear. So right away, we just go up to this arena. It's huge, it's awesome, it's, you know, something I always kind of wanted in the game. The arena, oh god, what was that? Pit Fighters, you know, added a perfect arena experience, and I loved that one, but this is just nice to duke it out with some stuff, but we're going to let the combatants themselves duke it out. We're going to activate a wolf now, a three bandits, a saber cat, and a bandit boss. And honestly, the wildlife needs the help because the bandits themselves are just so tough. But we'll watch this. See, look at that. The just fucking owned. These bandits just got owned, or the fucking giants got owned, and there were three of them. There we go. Make it a little bit more even. I found that if there's enough giants, they just kind of stun the bandits into submission. It's quite funny. Alright, so let's just go down and finish these fuckers off myself.
That takes care of that.
That takes care of that. You said it, arena fan. So all the people in there are pretty much just the arena fans. I think there's a couple guards. There is definitely a couple guards. But we're just gonna take these mother truckers out. And just one big swing. It's kind of neat that we can just summon these bandits. One thing I was really liking, and I probably shouldn't have been doing so much, was I just kept killing these guys for their loot. So if you just come over here and you can summon them right here as well, which is neat. So like we'll just summon one bandit chief. It doesn't matter because we're just gonna bash his fucking head in. Funnily enough, I swear the normal bandits are tougher than the bandit chiefs, but that could just be because I have organized bandits of Skyrim. So you know, whatever. But the arena, it's a very cool thing, very neat idea, very cool way to farm gear. Definitely, probably not intended. It's probably very much intended, you know, just fighting normal bandits, but of course I have, many mods that add different kind of bandits, and I have the organized bandits, and whew.
What do you need, Hansa?
I'm pretty sure that was all I had to note. The Hunter's Guild is pretty basic. There's not really much in there. This is kind of like a just a little tavern, I believe. I don't remember. This is actually quite lovely. It's like a little small area. Probably be nice for screenshots and stuff. At least that's what I think. Definitely nice for RPing, I'd say. But, you know, just this whole mountain is beautiful, and the way he built around it is absolutely beautiful. Hunter's Guild's pretty basic as well. You can get in there and get the book, like I did with the knight thing. So, you know, we got, I think this is the home that you own. And this is the home you own. What is this? I don't know what that is. That's funny. Huh.
Not all the passions are virtuous. Greed, lust, and rage, to name a few. But those are the obvious ones. Guilt is the one people often forget. Because it always comes after the others.
Huh. Wasn't expecting a philosophy today, but yeah. Beep, beep, beep. Okay, god damn it, Tina. So, here is another thing that's been added by this mod that I wanted to show off. We're going to get to the very last thing in just a second, which is probably one of the cooler things. I don't know about one of the cooler things, but this whole mod's pretty cool. But this is the sewers. And one of the things you'll hear from the citizens and guards that, strangely, we haven't, is that this croaker problem in the sewers. So, it's just these Argonians who, I believe, are just referred to as lizard men, living in the sewers, and they're just, like, overpopulated it. Nothing really happens when you kill them all, but it's kind of neat, and they have their own custom shield, which is kind of cool. they're all the same thing. Same green-skinned male Argonian, with the Forsworn armor and the sword and the shield. But it's really cool, and I just thought I'd show you that. The sewer is designed very well as well. It looks very nice. Surprisingly, a lot of time probably put into that sewer. just ignore me. So this on this side is the noble's quarters. On that side is an armory. So it pretty much just has mannequins and places to put all your swords and stuff. Which is cool and nice and stuff. And you can kind of see right away from this, if you recognize this, it is the, like, Windhelm palace design. Which is probably the most remarkable looking one. So definitely a good choice there. But the reason I was going to pick up this guy and the reason I didn't is because of the stuff in this chest right here. And the character already has this stuff. And it's the king's armor. So I didn't want to... Oh, jeez, where is this? Necessarily just, like, skip that and forget that this stuff existed. Where is it? What was it called again? Son of a bitch. Ah, King of Riverhelm armor. Probably should have just went to the armor, first of all. But, yeah, you can get a nice look at that. Obviously, it doesn't come with a helm, necessarily. It comes with this crown in here, which, is this power helmet? Oh, god damn it. Or at least that's what the mod creator calls it. It's the Crown of Riverhelm. So we'll just go back to C. And, yeah, it's a very basic, amulet, type of deal. And there is a way to go up. It's a tower that overlooks, Whiterun. And we'll save that for last, I think. Just to end the thing on a nice note. But we got this suspicious cabinet here, which kind of leaves us to this secret way. And I like these little mannequin guys, because you can change their poses. I don't know where this came from. But you can just, like, put all your armor on there and then change their pose and stuff. It's quite interesting. That's probably one of my favorites, because it just looks like a dead guy. And if you, like, take the armor off of him, it's like you're looting it. Some knight who, you know, or something fell in somewhere and you're taking it off of him, or he's just there immortalized forever like that. So this is the way to go to another secret area within the secret area. Not that secret, though, but we're just going to open this up. I love every time you open a place like this, and then that music of, like, oh, please. But look at this beautiful place. Absolutely incredible looking. Just huge, and you could put, you know, weapons all over. You can... There's so many mannequins that it's insane. I don't know how I could ever fill up all these mannequins. Oh, that sounds a little dirty. But, wow. That's all I can say there. Youth Grimoire statues are always epic as fuck. And then I think these statues are in Sovngarde? I may be mistaken, though. But then we have this little, like, fire pit here. It looks awesome. And just this whole place looks awesome in general. We also have these little display cases, which are cool as well. And this whole area is just meant to display your achievements within the game, which I thought was really cool. And it looks really beautiful. Just kind of wow factor, you know. So I like this very much. I love like underground sacred grove type of things. I'm gonna close that Durnture up. But we're gonna continue on, and I'm not gonna go through this door. But I'm going to show it to you, just because it pretty much just pops you right out of the castle. And you can get back into the castle this way. So that's kind of a neat idea, a neat thing that, you know, you got a trap door in and out of the castle. Kind of in the same vein of an actual king would have an actual escape route. Pretty cool. gonna go through the suspicious cabinet and close it, and we're going to go up back into Skyrim. So we just have this big like watchtower like thing above everything and anything, that you have this beautiful view of Whiterun, and just absolutely incredible. And you get this really big view of your own city of Riverhelm, which it's just immense, isn't it? And I love the way it's inside the mountain kind of thing. I love the building of medieval.
Running through the trees, you don't even feel boosh! The feet. It's like you're really flying.
Anyway, I meant to kind of throw you off there, but you know, whatever. You're not Serana, so whatever, I guess. But it's just a great mod. It's a great. It's. I can't even describe how huge just the city looks and feels, and that's just incredible, really. But it's definitely a mod you should definitely try out and get for yourself. It's, like I said before, I wouldn't, like, replace this with High King of Skyrim, or I wouldn't replace High King of Skyrim with this. I'd play it with it, because I think it works really well together. But if you ever have troubles with High King of Skyrim, this is absolutely the mod I would say. Just playing, it's awesome. You're a king, you feel like a king. You command an army if you want to. You know, you can defend the place. And I want to be checking out Become Jarl of Iverstead as well. I will be checking that out. Both to see... it is the more recent one, as well as being a more Nordic one. Obviously, I believe it's more Nordic. I shouldn't say that for sure. But... I think this is awesome, and thanks for suggesting this. I will, of course, as I always do, put a link down in the description for this mod. And as always, have a hell of a week. Now somebody hit my music. Bye-bye!